Hi everyone, it's Janice. Today I have a really quick tutorial on the nail of the day that I had yesterday. I already started taking it off, so I'm just going to go ahead and show you what I did to get this nail. So I have my three colors. Basically, you find one color and then have a light one, a dark one, and then I used like a complementary glitter color that complements the other two. So again, this first one is Aren't You Gladius by Finger Paints. This one right here is Amethyst by Simple Colors, and this one is All Is Glam, All Is Bright by Nicole Pye OPI, the Kardashian Christmas Collection. So I'm going to go ahead and get started. Okay, the first thing I did was paint my nail with one coat of the Finger Paints Aren't You Gladius, and I just put on one coat of that so it's not too thick. Wait for it to dry, and then I took this striping tape, and you can get this striping tape off of eBay. If you don't want to go through eBay, I do have names of several of my friends that do sell nail art, and they have these striping tapes, so just let me know and I can refer you to someone. And if my voice is kind of funny, I caught a cold. I don't know how, but anyway, so I'm just going to take off about a little, like maybe an inch. And I'm just going to make a pattern, and I'm going to try to do this on camera. But basically you just stick it in a tic-tac-toe pattern and make sure your edges are flush, like right here where the cuticle meets. Make sure that you have it's all the way down. And then I like to just kind of secure it. So that's one. I'm going to go ahead and do a one right there and then two across to make the tic-tac-toe pattern, and I'll be right back. Okay, so I made sure that all my corners were flush against the edge. You can see that, and I'm done with the checkerboard / tic-tac-toe pattern. So I'm going to take the next color, which is Amethyst by Simple Colors. And I'm going to do the four corners and the middle. And what I like to do is, you know how you paint your nails and you kind of go flat like that? Instead of doing the flat way, I'm going to kind of flatten it out and kind of do it with the edge of the brush. And you see how it's dripping? I'm going to make sure that there's very little product on the brush. So I'm going to go ahead and fill in the edges. And if you get on the edge where your skin is, don't worry, because you're going to clean it up. You can also use a nail art brush if you have one, or a dotter to get the small spaces. But I'll just do it like this. And And I just want to get a little bit more on the edges. Okay, so that's my purple. Make it a little bit darker. Then I'm going to take my glitter, which is the All is Glam, All is Bright, right here. And I'm going to fill in the other four edges. And it's hard to get this in camera. Okay. And again, working with very little product. This brush is pretty wide, so I'm going to turn it to its side and do it like that. And I'm going to color right here. And then get a little bit more product on the brush. Right here. Right here. And then on the side. And then I'm going to wait for it to dry. It really doesn't take that long. But then I'll take off the tape and you'll see how it looks. So I'm going to wait for that to dry and I'll be right back. Okay, so it's been a couple of minutes and I think I'm ready to go ahead and take off the striping tape. It's still a little bit tacky. Sometimes I like to wait till it's all the way dry, but I'll go ahead for time's sake and do it now since I'm going to take off this design anyway. When you pull off the striping tape, it's better to pull back, straight back, kind of like if you were waxing. If you're waxing, you're going to pull it straight back really quickly instead of pulling it up. So that's what I'm going to do. So if I remember right, I did the ones going across first. So that's the way I'm going to pull off the striping tape, is doing the ones across first, because those are the last ones. If I pulled this one, then it'll just bring up everything. So right here, I'm going to pull back, and you can't see it. Pull back the striping tape, and you can see there's a pretty clean line. I'm going to do the next one, and pull back, and then the same with the this. I'm just going to pull back this way. And then this one. Okay. So those are the lines. They're really clean lines. What I'll do is I'll clean up around the edges using a toothpick, or not toothpick, a Q-tip. I like the pointed ones because you can get the edges. And then I'll seal it with a top coat. A lot of people, when they get this far, they think that it's kind of clumpy and stuff. Don't worry about it, because when you put on your top coat, it's going to level it out. So if it is kind of thick for your liking, try it with a top coat, let it settle, and see how it turns out. So I'm just going to clean up my edges. And then I'm going to seal it with a top coat. And I'm using the Out the Door. This is my Out the Door bubble bottle. I usually go with Sesh Feet, but since I'm doing the one polish every day, I don't want to go through all the Sesh Feet. So that is the finished product. and hope you enjoyed. So this is my second tutorial I have ever done. So I don't know all the editing stuff, so I hope you're able to hang in there with me, as I'm not used to doing this. So anyway, I hope you enjoy. Please rate, comment, subscribe. Bye.